Casas Hill Stadium. I'm Jose Mora alongside Kuki Rojas as it's coming down to the last day, even though we already have a champion. How about this, Kuki? The sun is out, finally.
Well, thanks God. It's a good day right here, and it seemed like a little edgy at the beginning with the rain, but everything turned out all right.
Very nice. Our starting lineups are presented by the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic has it all. For manager Eduardo Perez, Jesus Feliciano leading off. He led off with a home run yesterday against the Dominican team. Followed by Figueroa, Gonzalez, Rivera, de-aging today, Jorge Padilla, MVP of the league in right field, Cortez, for Mainz, Iggy Suarez, and veteran Eli Marrero. He's behind the plate. He is a personal catcher of the guy on the mound, Giancarlo Alvarado. Beautiful sight on this shot from Mexicali and Casas Hill. Umpires ready to take the field, and that's a good sign, Kuki, considering all the rain, the threat perhaps of the last day being washed out. Well, it didn't happen, but you know, the recipe for a champion goes in so many ways, and I already talked about the guy in the mound, Knox, setting the deal in that first game.
I'll tell you what, he had great stuff, no hits allowed in 6 1/3 innings. Buddy Bailey, the manager, took a big chance in that situation when a guy pitching a no-hitter to walk up to the mound and go to his bullpen. When you see the whole series, then you know the kind of a job the bullpen has done for the Aragua team. They've done a fantastic job. Yeah. In hitting, Alex Delgado leading the club with .455 average. And then in five games, the hitters, 7, 8, 9 hitters, are going 5-for-14 with 3 RBIs. They haven't been hitting as well, but they have done fundamentally right all the things that they have to do to win.
And one thing they've done so well to win is catch the ball. Other than Knox on the mound, Gonzalez, Castro, Nunez, Ugueto. Out of the lineup is Maza, who has been really the guy who has inspired this ball club. But they've also shown a lot of range in the outfield. Meliana in right field with some good catches. And Langen in center field really takes charge.
Well, he's given a chance to Abel Nieves to play shortstop and get Maza a little time off. You know, he's a great ball player. I think he's done great. And I believe that when the voting comes at the end of the day, I think for the most valuable player, you have to consider Luis Maza and also Buto, that reliever with the 4 saves, and you know, during the whole season. I think it's fantastic. And in a matter of fact, it's a record in Caribbean Series.
He established a record, 4 saves for Buto in the Caribbean Series. For Venezuela, well, you mentioned Buddy Bailey, the manager, and how he was the one guy that's not very popular after the first game. So now he is. And looking at tonight on MLB Network, Alex Rodriguez and the steroid allegations. We're going to have some reaction and analysis from Harold Reynolds and Tom Verducci. And Bob Costas will sit down with Sports Illustrated senior writer Selena Roberts, who broke the story. That's at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on the MLB Network. Brad Knox, we'll see him today with that tremendous stuff, that good curveball. Boy, he established that very early, didn't he?
He had a very good curveball, established his fastball, changed speed on those gloves, and did an outstanding job on the mound.
Maza 4-for-5 that opening ball game. You mentioned an MVP and a leader, the guy that set everything up for them.
And defensively also did the job at shortstop, covering a lot of ground and very accurate arm. I think he's an all-around ball player and he has a good chance to stick in the big leagues.
He'll be in Dodger camp competing for a spot on the bench. And Puerto Rico, a big win for them, breaking that streak of 11 consecutive losses yesterday when they beat the Dominican.
They save face, and Bill Pulsifer, I'll tell you what, he did a great job in the mound, being left-handed, 6-1 1/3 of an inning, 1 earned run, 7 Ks. Luis Figueroa hitting .357, a double and 3 RBI for their offense. And Carlos Rivera also .350, 7-for-20, 2 RBIs. But when they needed it, it just didn't work out well for them. And it was not a ready ball club that we have seen in the past Puerto Rico represented this year in the Caribbean Series.
And going back to history, 11 undefeated champions in series history. The last time, well, believe it or not, it was Venezuela and the Leones de Caracas, when the Leones went 6-0 playing in the homeland. And Cuba was the first undefeated team in the first series in Estadio del Cerro in 1949.
That's going back way back, and Venezuela has a chance in this first game right now. If they can beat Puerto Rico, will be the undefeated team since 2006 to do it again. And I'll tell you what, we have to give our best to Buddy Bailey. I think he's done a fantastic job managing that club. The last 6 years that he's been in the playoff and into the series haven't been able to win. This year, finally, he got that crown and take it back to Venezuela, where they're going to have a big party when this club gets back.
Last 5 years, there's a look. Mexico, Venezuela, Dominican twice, and Venezuela again. Is it important, you think, for those guys to go undefeated at this point?
I think that it would be great, you know, if you come to a series and say, hey, we are undefeated, beating everybody that we face. But I think that they have to give credit to all the players, the way they play the game fundamentally. And also one important thing about this series, Venezuela didn't bring their big guns, their big stars. They just brought a bunch of players that knew how to play, got together as a team, and played fundamentally right baseball with tremendous pitching. When you're talking about a pitching in six games or five games with only a 1-point-some ERA, that is a fantastic job they have done.
You're talking about guys like Luis Rodriguez with the Padres, Miguel Cabrera himself, Matt Tolbert, Sam Fold, Ronnie Cedeño. And there's so many good things about Venezuela, but also in a series, Kuki, we get to discover or rediscover some of the things from the past, like a Bill Pulsifer.
Well, it's good to see Bill Puffers coming around. I believe that action that he did the other day, pitching, starting that ball game, throwing that curveball, the fastball, his enthusiasm. It seemed like his arm is in good shape, and that's the one thing that was hurting before. He threw a lot of pitches, walked a lot of people. It seems like now that he's got a rhythm, he struck out, you know, 11 guys. And I think that's a great action for him to get a chance to play again, maybe at least in the spring training for a ball club to look at.
And as you mentioned, if you're lefty and you can throw a slider for a strike and get lefties out, you have a long life.
Especially that curveball over with, you know, behind the count. If you can throw that pitch for a strike, you've got a good chance to stay.
There's a first look at Brad Knox on the mound. We saw him the first game. Outstanding performance, worked fast. Taken out of the game by Buddy Bailey, as I mentioned before. Not a very popular man after the first game, even though he won. But today, is there anybody more popular than Buddy Bailey in Venezuela?
No question right now. His name is all over the board, and I think he's excited. And I think it's going to be a great crowd receiving this club back in Caracas, Venezuela, when they fly into La Guaira. The one thing he's going to see today, I believe, and I'm going to mention about it, I think, right now, is the fact that I don't think that Knox is going to be able to pitch more than 3 or 4 innings. I don't think he's going to utilize any of his pitches a long way. He already won the Caribbean Series. So why force any of these youngsters? Maybe give a chance to the younger pitchers that he has in the bullpen to go ahead and get into the Caribbean Series pitching against Puerto Rico with no pressure whatsoever.
Brad Knox, property of the Oakland Athletics organization. And they are set to go with a lot of pride. They take the field as they go back to Maracay. Jesus Feliciano, Luis Figueroa, and Andy Gonzalez for Eduardo Perez's team.
Well, they finally won that game, so now at least they can go back to Puerto Rico with a win and possibility maybe getting two on this series.
Mentioned before, 11 consecutive games. Not the country of Puerto Rico, but the team of Ponce had lost in Caribbean Series action, dating back to 1982. Sky to the right side, trouble, and this will find the line inside and thrown out at second base as Feliciano.
And they got him out. He's trying to stand it after the ball dropping the line in right field. And the wind had a lot something to do with that ball. The second baseman was pacing that ball. And all of a sudden, that ball carried a little bit further out, dropped it. But they still had a chance to get the runner to second base.
I wonder if he ran fast or not. That ball was up there a long time. trouble all the way for the second baseman.
I think he just thought it was an easy out. And that's why you have to give 100% all the time until the guy catches the ball or the player.
There is a strike to Luis Figueroa. That'll be a single for Feliciano, thrown out 9-6. As we see Ozzie Guillen in the presence of the White Sox and the billboard. Another fly ball right side, this time to the right fielder, Jackson Melian. And there's two down.
I think we're going to see a lot of first pitch swings in today's game, Jose.
You know what? And this is going to bring me back to almost that last day of spring training when people know they have to catch a plane or get in their cars and start driving up. And the umpire has a way bigger zone. Brad Knox went 6 1/3, no hits allowed. One run. He walked 5 on Monday, striking out 5 against the Dominican team. And his run was allowed by the reliever, Joan Pino, who gave up a home run to Ronnie Belliard after he had walked the previous batter with one out. Andy Gonzalez stands in for Puerto Rico, hitting third. He's playing first base. Gonzalez brings a 263 average, 6'3", 205, 27-year-old. Had some time with the Indians in 2008. And at some point right now, Knox is trying to just establish that fastball. We will see that breaking ball sooner or later. Big swing by Gonzalez. Green light 3-0, why not?
Well, he's got a pretty good arm. You know, he's got a good curveball, a good changeup. He's got a very well-coordinated movement to home plate. The thing that he has to do, though, Jose, is try to keep those pitches in the strike zone low. Sometimes he gets a little high up there.
Hard shot, base hit, left field. Andy Gonzalez is aboard. Gonzalez had a long home run yesterday over the center field wall over the 400-foot sign. Oh, he's off to a nice finish in the 2009 Caribbean Series. And here comes Carlos Rivera.
He's having a good series. 7 hit and 20 times at bat, 350.
Fouls it off to the left side. He played for the Brother Elephants in Taiwan recently.
They say that they're starting to play pretty good ball in Taiwan.
Right now, you know, Taiwan and even Italy, Korea is providing opportunities for so many players that no longer can find work in the U.S. or in Mexico in the summertime. I have friends that played in Holland.
In Holland?
Yes.
Wow.
1-2 to Rivera. Puerto Rico comes in with a 1-4 mark. And Venezuela, the champions at 5-0.
Is the weather different in Holland like here? I mean, summer is summer and winter is winter like in the States, or sometimes it reverses?
I have to ask my friend about that because I don't know. But obviously they picked the summer to play,
that, you know,
in good weather.
Mm-hmm. For example, if you're talking about going into, let's say, Buenos Aires in South America, in the summertime, it's cold. In the wintertime, it's warm.
All different climates all throughout, but Emmanuel's going to be pretty decent to be outside playing baseball in the summertime. And Italy, the league, play a couple times a week, 2-3 times a week. Here's a 2-2 on Rivera. This is now with a changeup, now a full count.
So he gets the first two hitters quickly on a hit, of course, Feliciano, a ball that dropped there behind the second baseman, and he was thrown out at second base trying to get there before, you know, he wasn't running. Then try to rush, but he was thrown out, and then Figueroa on the first pitch. And now, after Gonzalez got a base hit, again, he gets to the 3-2 count. So now he's starting to throw a lot of pitches where you don't want to see him to do that.
Oh, there that tarp has been busy. He made three pitches of the first two hitters. So now here's pitch number 14 to the last two.
Yes, sir.
We saw that thing roll up last night. We're like, oh, it could be a long day.
Sure helped a lot to put that on. Otherwise, everybody's having troubles right now.
A great job by the grounds crew getting the field ready here in Casas Hayo Stadium. Another 3-2 to Carlos Rivera. As the runner goes, he lines a shot to right field, base hit. Melian will bring it into the infield as Gonzalez makes it all the way to third. It'll be first and third for Puerto Rico, and that is a third hit already against Knox, who did not allow a hit in 6 1/3 in his first outing.
Right now, I don't think that they're going 100%. Jose, I think they're just trying to throw strikes and get the thing, getting his work in. Venezuela already celebrating last night, you know, the championship.
Here's the MVP of the league, Jorge Padilla, who continues to struggle. And another chance for the second baseman. This time he plays it right with the wind, and two are stranded here in the top of the first for Puerto Rico. As the Campeones from La Guaira will come up to hit in the first. Well, Cookie, if the party is big here in Mexicali for these young men from Maracay, how about when they get home?
It's going to be a big, exciting day for them when they get back, and I think they deserve it. They earn it. And taking back the title back to Venezuela is going to be very exciting for them.
Our starting lineups are presented by the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic has it all, except a good record here in the Caribbean Series. Rodney Medina, Luis Sugueto, the first two. Hector Jimenez will follow against Giancarlo Alvarado. Jackson Melian, Selvin Langane, Castro, Nunez, Nieves, and Gonzalez. A lineup for the champions from Tigres de Aragua. And manager Buddy Bailey.
Alvarado, the right-hander, the three-quarter to the top sides.
Medina is retired 1-3 on a good cut fastball by Alvarado, one out. And many young players getting opportunities, something you mentioned off the air, Cookie, to get exposure and say, hey, I did play for the champions on the field too.
Not only that, it gives a chance to their managers just to go see how these kids are performing and thinking about the future. As we know, Buddy Bailey has been a set manager there in Aragua for 6 or 7 years. And I think he likes to see these kids make some progress to help him out in the future. And talking about Alvarado, he struck out 11 in his first outing. 5 2/3 innings, 5 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned runs. 3.18 ERA. He's got pretty good stuff.
Throws and across his body and very deceptive. He hides the ball real well. Hard shot foul by batter Luis Sugueto.
The one thing he does is he throws cross body. He throws his body to the right side and throws, try to go with his arm over to the hitter. I mean, sometimes that is good for the ball sinking, but sometimes the ball runs away from home plate, stay high because he can't get down after he's delivered. So if you watch the windup, how he goes over toward third base, not as much on that one.
The big man, he certainly uses his whole body coming forward and across his body to hide the ball so well and get in on those lefties. Good pitch by Alvarado. And re-records another strikeout here in the Caribbean Series, and that is now 12 kooky for him in 6 1/3. Defensively, Eliezer Marrero, his personal catcher behind the plate. Andy Gonzalez plays first. He's very versatile. Iggy Suarez, Fernando Cortez, Luis Figueroa round out the infield. For Maine, Feliciano and Padilla from left to right.
Defense means a lot. When you have pitchers that can throw a strike, your defense is right on their toes. Instead of a pitcher throwing too many balls, all of a sudden you go back to your heels and you don't have the same break when the ball is hit to you. Use your defense when nobody on base. Make him hit the ball.
26-year-old Hector Jimenez takes outside. Jimenez hit 7 home runs, Cookie, in the Venezuelan postseason and a game winner here against Mexico.
Well, that means he has some pop. So you got to be careful with him.
Comes in 1 for 20, but that one, a game winner. And that's been the story about this ball club throughout the whole series.
Well, they've been trying to hit that ball out of the ballpark, as you well know, you know, especially the team from Puerto Rico. The team from Dominican Republic. Everybody has that big, long swing from down to up, trying to get under the ball, and it just didn't work for them.
A lot of uppercuts. Here's 1 and 2, nobody on. First inning, no score. Good pitch again. Alvarado is a punch-up machine. He strikes out 2 out of 3. As we take a look, only 10 pitches that inning for Alvarado. Langane celebrated last night their championship for Aragua. We'll be back for the second. Coming up after the game, don't miss an MLB Network special report on Alex Rodriguez allegedly having tested positive for steroids during the 2003 American League MVP season. MLB Network's Bob Costas has a first interview with Selena Roberts, the senior Sports Illustrated writer who broke the story. That's an MLB Network special report coming up right after the game. Puerto Rico comes up to hit for the second time. Their number 6 hitter, Fernando Cortez, takes low from Brad Knox. It'll be Cortez, Charlie Vermaint, and Iggy Suarez. Still haven't seen the big breaking ball, Cookie, from Brad Knox.
He's been having a little problem right now to get ahead of the hitters. I think that he'll see it when he gets ahead in the count.
There's a little slider he throws to the lefty as Cortez is taking care of 4-3. There's Ricky Bones saying hi to the whole Bones family.
He's pretty young, yeah. You know?
Eduardo Perez told me before the series, there's a future major league pitching coach in Ricky Bones.
That's good news. I'll tell you what, if you work hard at whatever trade you are as a player and learn the game, and try to teach the game and ask a lot of questions about the game, you can stay in the game a long time. And Bunnies have decided to stay in it as a pitching coach. And like you mentioned, maybe the possibility in the future to be in the big league club.
I'll tell you, did a great job for the Seattle Mariners also as a pitching coach from Puerto Rico. Was Rafi Chavez a couple of years back. An outstanding job, especially in guiding a guy like the King, Felix Hernandez. Got away with one right there, 2-2 to Charlie Vermaint. Good breaking ball. There it is.
There it was. With 2 strikes, he came that good curve ball blocked by the catcher for the second out. And he's got a good one, Jose. He's got that real from 12 to 6. You can see that rotation.
And drops off the table.
It's almost unhittable.
Look at that.
If he can maintain it there in that spot. Look at him. He's smiling, saying, boy, that would fool the heck out of him, you know?
when pitchers jam somebody, they get in your kitchen, will make you look bad in a breaking ball like that. There's a reason to show that smile.
Absolutely.
Even though they may not show it to you right away, but inside they're just
laughing.
Iggy Swatter's number 8 hitter. And today he's shown that short slider even more. Maybe something that the A's or perhaps he wants to work on himself.
Or maybe they're trying to teach him that kind of a cutter so that he don't have to force the slider on the curveball. It's like the Dodgers. The Dodgers don't teach their pitching staff throughout the years that I remember to throw a slider. They'd rather have them throw the curveball and they take away the slider. But now, if it's a cutter, it's a different story because that's just a short break off the fastball. Effective against left-handed for right-handed pitchers and then effective versus right-handed from left-handed pitchers.
When you played, what was a cutter called?
No, the cutter para nosotros was a slider, but it broke a lot more.
To the left side, Nieves retires. Suarez 1-2-3 inning after allowing 3 hits in the first inning. Knox looks like Knox again. Casas Hale Stadium 2009 Caribbean Series. So glad you joined us all week. We've had a fantastic time here. And what a job they've done for the first time as Mexicali hosts the Caribbean Series. This is the home of the Aguilas for Mexicali in winter ball. And they invested, Kuki, about $1.5 million in this ballpark, in this facility.
Wow, I tell you, it's beautiful. They treated us very well. It's very well kept ballpark, and I think the fans had enjoyed it so much that you saw even last night 19,000 people watched that doubleheader yesterday.
You know, he's enjoyed it. You know, Buddy
Bailey,
says,
he's happy.
I conquered it.
Yes.
You built it for me.
Yes. After so many years of trying, they finally got that Caribbean Series title. I think they well deserve. Buddy Bailey, his coaching staff, the ownership. Our congratulations.
Here's Jackson Melian. He'll be followed by Selwyn Langane. And then Ramon Castro. Boy, look at that. Well, they're going to have to spend more money now, Cookie. How about that?
Wow. That sometimes is unbelievable. But see what happened. The ball hit just on the corner where the line is coming down. The end of it. And I guess that's what caused the break. But as you can see, the glass didn't break all over. It's just kind of shattered. And that lady behind home plate almost.
And we promise you, no, you're not watching hockey.
Yep. Wow. I think that gentleman that is sitting right behind that, we look over our box here in Mexicali, you know, he better get out of there. You know, you see him there with the hat over there. They see the guy with the blue jacket over there. He's kind of sleeping and he don't know that that thing broke down.
Oh, he's comfortable.
Look at him. Oh, he said, oh, wait a minute. What was that?
This one hit in the air and deep to left field. It's against the base of the wall. Melian will cruise to second base with a leadoff double here in the second inning for the champion Venezuelan team.
Well, he got a hold of that one very well. Pulled it. Line shot over the left fielder set for a double. Nobody out. And the Tigres of Aragua again. With man in scoring position.
Melian showing all that power. On a day like today, the air is cooler and perhaps the ball not traveling as much. We saw the ball travel a lot yesterday.
There's a little, you know, breeze right here in Mexicali. I guess that has to do with the early morning kind of a little gray clouds that came around, a little bit of a rain, but things got everything has gone away, and baseball is being played.
Selwyn Langane, you mentioned him on the top of the show as to hitting that ground ball. They got things going for Venezuela, opening up the score last night against Mexico. Good fundamental baseball, the ground ball the first.
That gave him the lead last night. What a job they have done. I mean, That's true.
To Langane. And how about Mike Brito? We've talked about Mike Brito, the great scout for the Dodgers, sitting behind home plate and practically all these games. Maybe they told him that he had to be careful because the glass was giving up or something today.
I tell you what, it's very dangerous right now with that glass being broken like it is in chatter. If another ball hits there, then that's a good chance that glass flies all over the place. There's a timeout right now, and the pitchers and the catcher coming over to the mound discussing the situation with man at second base. Many times we have mentioned, Jose, that the reason why they get together sometime with the man on second is to change the signs. Because if they only give one finger or two finger, one for a fastball, two for a curveball, then the runner at second base can relate to the batter what kind of a pitch that pitcher is throwing home plate.
Oh, Cookie, that doesn't happen. Come on.
You
nobody does that. Nah. Throw the right side, base hit. Here comes Padilla, and they will hold Melian at third base as Venezuela now has been first and third here to lead off the second inning.
Good piece of hitting there right now by Langane with man on second base, nobody out. Having the patience to wait for a pitch that he can pull. He did that, and that ball goes right through first and second base for a base hit to right field, advancing to third base, Melian.
And here's a point you've been saying since we took the mic the first game. Playing baseball that is unselfish. Langane's priority right there, even though they're still the champions, was to get that guy over. He ends up with a bonus. Base
hit. Absolutely nobody out, man on first and third now, and there is a rally going right now. That's what baseball is all about.
Here's Ramon Castro. Short right field. Second baseman going out. He makes a catch as Melian will stay pat at third base. Now with one out. So Castro's retired. And that'll bring up Alex Nunez.
Alex Nunez playing second base.
Alex Nunez, segunda base. Nunez.
For Venezuela, and there is Knox, who so far had thrown 34 pitches, 21 for strike, 13 bases on balls. So let's see how long will he stay in the mound. Buddy Bailey, the manager of the Tigres of Aragua, is always checking with his pitching coach as far as how many pitches this kid can be able to throw.
Here's Alex Nunez, 27 year old. Alvarado holds a runner, comes home, and Melian will be thrown out.
Well,
some hesitation originally, Cookie, but perhaps Alvarado did something right. He started with the ball.
Well, the one thing I would say on this play right now is that I wouldn't have not sent that runner to home plate because it was so slow that there was a possibility of a double play anyway. So stay at third base. You know, he has to go, maybe go out, get the out at first base, and you still got runners in a scoring position. But now, instead of a third base, you got a man on second base and first.
So a fielder's choice, 1-2 on the putout. As Nunez is aboard, first and second, as you say. Now with two outs, they have first and third with nobody out. Here's Abel Nieves. And Alvarado delivers strike one. Sending some birthday wishes all the way to San Juan, Puerto Rico. Short slider again for a strike, 0-2 to Abel Nieves. We have seen fans from everywhere, including many from the U.S., making the trek down just. And Eduardo Perez's daughter also celebrating her birthday today. So, feliz cumpleaños, pequeña.
So, where is he going to take his little daughter?
There's strike three. On the hitter, Abel Nieves. Opportunity gone to the ground for the champions. Coming up after the game, don't miss an MLB Network special report on Alex Rodriguez allegedly having tested positive for steroids during his 2003 American League MVP season. MLB Network's Bob Costas has the first interview with Selena Roberts, the senior Sports Illustrated writer who broke the story. That's an MLB Network special report coming up right after the game. Moving on to the top of the third inning for Puerto Rico, Eli Marrero. He'll be followed by Jesus Feliciano and then Luis Figueroa. It's good to see Eli in that uniform again, huh?
It sure is. You know, he's been around in the big leagues. Former catcher, he can play the outfield too.
Hey, he likes a base hit. Yeah, Eduardo Perez was telling me he mainly brought him because I want him to catch Giancarlo Alvarado.
Well, that's smart from Eduardo. I mean, you want a veteran catcher always behind the plate when a young pitcher is on the mound to try to help him out in any way he can, to mix his pitchers, to make him throw different speeds, calm him down when he gets a little bit upset.
They really are giving it to Eli Marrero at first base, his first hit in three trips to the plate. Jesus Feliciano had a bloop single in his first at bat, but he got thrown out trying to stretch it into a double. As the ball was really cookie mishandled by the second baseman Nunez. A pop-up that stayed up there a long time. But you think his mistake really was in the base running, huh?
Absolutely. I don't think that he ran, otherwise he would have made it easy to second base.
Now he says the line drive shot to left field, base hit. First and second for Puerto Rico. So Feliciano off to a nice finish in the series. He's 2 for 2.
He takes that pitch on the outside, a bit high, and went inside out to left field. Line shot. And we mentioned it very few times during the series. Any hitter that we have seen inside out, other guys have been hitting the ball very well.
They've had success staying back.
That's right.
Puerto Rico, 34 men left on base this series. Great idea. Pushes a bunt. First baseman Fields look to second to first. Too late. Super bunt by Luis Figueroa, and Puerto Rico has the bases loaded and nobody out here in the third inning.
And that was a great play right there by Figueroa, taking the ball with him over between the pitcher and the first baseman. And after the first baseman went after the pitch, he had no chance to get him out of first base, and that ends up with man on first, second, and third, bases loaded.
That's already six hits allowed by Brad Knox in two plus innings.
It's pitch count getting up there now. Nobody out. A very good bunt, moving those runners over and then getting himself a base hit.
A much looser Puerto Rican team after getting the monkey off their backs yesterday. The Ponce Leones had lost 11 consecutive Caribbean Series games. Stayed back on that one. And it's in short center field. Langane coming in, not able to get a base hit. Scoring from third is the catcher Marrero, and Puerto Rico takes a 1-0 lead. RBI single for Andy Gonzalez. He's also 2 for 2.
I think that ball really fooled the center fielder Langane. It seemed like he was playing a little bit deep. He didn't get it off the bat too well because he didn't come in hard enough. Look at him. He just. That ball in front, dropping right in front of him.
One thing for sure, a big difference, Cookie, between the previous games we've done with the afternoon start is you see there's no shadow because of the sky. And There's Shadow or not a base hit by Carlos Rivera. Here comes one run in Feliciano. And Figueroa will follow a two-run single for the cleanup hitter Rivera. And it's a 3-0 lead for Leones de Ponce.
Well, now, finally, the offense from the Ponce Leones is starting to work on the last day of this Caribbean Series. Five consecutive hits.
That's two RBIs there for Carlos Rivera. Gives him four for the series. And that leads a Puerto Rican team. About this, Padilla trying to bunt.
What do you think about that one?
Me? I don't like it.
I don't either. Not in this situation right now. You already got three runs.
Well, guess what the rain brings?
Well, all more, the pitches.
More food for the birds.
That's right.
There's some more worms ringing around. Gusanitos.
Early bird get the worm, right?
That's right. That's why they came to the first game, not the second game.
Good block there by the catcher, Ramos.
Tell you what, I really enjoyed it yesterday that implemented here on MLB Network, Cookie, was being able to have the interaction with studio, with Harold Reynolds and Barry Larkin doing the demonstration on staying inside the ball. That is something new, is refreshing, a great innovation, and something that perhaps will be part of MLB Network forever.
I think it worked out very well. And most of all, it's great for the kids that are listening to this man talk about baseball, try to help him out fundamentally what to do, teach him the game of baseball. I think it's a great idea they have done, and they're going to continue doing that probably the whole year.
There's a deep drive to left field. Forget about it. And the Puerto Rican League MVP shows us why. And Puerto Rico takes a commanding 6-0 lead with nobody out here in the third inning.
And boy, that's about time for Padilla. Now hitting a 3-run home run and showing the kind of player that he was this year in Puerto Rico when he was declared the MVP. Well, most valuable player.
Knox came into the game with a 1.42 ERA. He has now given up 6 consecutive hits and 8 total.
Well, I mentioned to you that I didn't think he was going to be too long in this game, and that might be, or it could be, the last inning that he pitches here.
Strike to Fernando Cortez. He's 0-for-1, and he becomes the 7th hitter up here for Team Puerto Rico in the third inning. Everything got started by the veteran number 9 hitter Eli Marrero with a single to left. Here's another hard hit ball to right center field. This one will split the gap. It's a 7th consecutive hit here in the inning for Puerto Rico as Cortez will make his way with his sliding triple.
Boy, he's been hard. He's been hit hard.
And guess what? In this inning, they only need the double to hit for the cycle.
There was Eduardo Perez telling his hitter, Fermain, go to right field, man on third base, try to hit the ball in the middle to the right field area. That is absolutely correct.
15 pitches, 7 hits this inning.
Yeah, 49, 50, almost 50 pitches already.
I think it's time to get him out of there as soon as you can. thanks to Knox, the Venezuelans got off to a great start in that first game.
Pitching coach looks like Doug Rader.
It does.
Doesn't he?
El Gallo, the rooster.
Yeah. Here's Bailey watching over the situation and seeing he started getting hit very hard.
Talk about a wake up for the Leones. Wow.
11 straight series games have lost before their first win.
1-4 in 2009, and Ponce won the championship back in 1972, playing at the Dominican Republic.
Nobody out yet.
A six run inning for Puerto Rico against Venezuela. Vermeid misses on the breaking ball. He struck out his first at bat, so far the only strikeout by the Texan Brad Knox.
Trying to get that ball, curveball over, but he can't. And that's something that you have to go out as a catcher, go out on the mound, talk to your pitcher about. Just because they hit a couple of balls, or in this inning they're hitting pretty hard, don't go back just to curveball, curveball, curveball. Keep throwing the fastball. The only thing you have to do is locate it better in the plate.
Dodd swinging with a breaking ball. Two strikeouts for the pitcher Knox, both against Charlie Vermeid. The 2009 Caribbean World Series is presented by the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic has it all. Cookie, I'm about to agree with manager Jose Offerman on why they have struggled so much. And I know you're looking at me like, I know where you're going with this. They have struggled so much with that shadow. No shadow today. Look at Puerto Rico with six runs. And make it seven, a base hit for number eight hitter Iggy Suarez. Eight hits in the inning. Wow. Only one out.
And all nine men have gone to bat in this inning, and there's still only one out, and Puerto Rico leading 7-0.
Only one out. And the 10th batter in the inning, the men that got started all, Eli Marrero coming up again.
I think we're going to start seeing finally some action in the bullpen.
This one gets away from the catcher Gonzalez, and moving to second base is Iggy Suarez on the wild pitch. So, Cookie, you don't buy my theory of the shadow for the Dominican team. And Jose Offerman, I bring it up because a manager brought it up and said, yeah, I don't think we're swinging the bat so well because we have that shadow in the afternoon.
Well, we don't have any sun today. It kind of overcast because of the rain, you know, this morning. So actually there's no sun. Maybe the sun's starting to come out a little bit now at the end, but there's no shadow between home plate and the mound at this particular moment. So that's not an excuse.
An excuse still?
That's not an excuse.
And I mentioned as the Dominican will face Mexico tonight here on MLB Network. Eli gets under this one, and the first baseman Castro will put it away in foul territory for out number two. Top of the order again, Jesus Feliciano, who's 2-for-2. Is why what I imagine will be the last inning of work, or maybe even the last batter for Brad Knox.
Too many pitchers in three innings.
Puerto Rico, men in scoring position, outstanding right now. Cookie, 5-for-8.
Wow.
Looks like your numbers with men in scoring position, huh?
Absolutely.
Looks like Buddy Bailey finally had decided this is going to be it. He makes a call to the bullpen. And after 18 hitters, Brad Knox leaves, trailing 7-0. And with a man aboard at second base now with two outs for Puerto Rico. And what a wake up for the Leones de Ponce. We'll be back with more action from Mexicali. A 7-0 lead for Puerto Rico, looking for their second win of the series and trying to give Venezuela the first loss of the series. As Andrew Lorraine makes his way to the mound, he inherits a man at second base. That's Iggy Suarez. So what a turn of events, Cookie, for Brett Knox, the way things started to what he leaves before he heads home to the United States.
Well, his first start is almost throws a no-hitter in 6 1/3 inning. You know, he was taken out of the ball game because the manager, Bud Bailey, thought that it had enough. They have a count on him. So a few days go by, he gets back today on the mound, and boy, he hasn't been received by Puerto Rico too well. 7 runs, 11 hits in 2 2/3 innings.
Lorraine, the lefty, trying to also get his work in. One thing that Buddy Bailey has used now a couple times in this series, he has used relievers to start ball games. We saw Pino start a game, and he said that formula is something he thought about during the finals. It certainly worked. The other day, he used 6 pitchers against the Dominican, started with all relievers.
Obviously, I believe that he was missing some starters, right? That's the reason why he did that.
Jeff Farnsworth wasn't able to start.
Right.
Here's Feliciano up for the second time this inning. He is 2 for 2 so far. 1 for 1 this inning. Breaking ball down. The runner at second base, Suarez, belongs to Knox, who allowed 11 hits through 2 2/3. Big swing. And for Ponce, Cookie, we talked about players that were out for Aragua, but Ponce playing without Joe Thurston, Ranger Abercrombie, who you know very well. I want you to tell me more about Abercrombie. Javier Vasquez, Ivan Rodriguez helped him out in the finals, Luis Matos.
Those are pretty good players. That means a lot to the ball club. When you lose those people, then you can't come over and bring him to the Caribbean Series. Well, the same thing has happened to all of the clubs, though.
Feliciano gets hit. Not happy about it, but he'll take first base. It'll be first and second now for Puerto Rico with 2 outs here in the third.
Maquinaria de la Pasión, tu punto más alto. Anuncia Baba, Luis Figueroa. Valor corto.
When we were talking about Abercrombie, what I had mentioned to you in the past is there's a kid that has 5 tools. I mean, he can have power, arm, speed, good runner, steal bases, good defender. But he hasn't been able to establish himself because he strikes out a lot from the right side. And what I said many a times was the fact that a guy with this type of ability, why don't you make him a switch hitter? If you do that and he can bunt the ball very well, runs like a deer. So he might hit 250 just by bunting the ball. And if he does that, get 250, he's going to steal 60 bases.
Breaking ball hung, and this will find the gap in right center field for Luis Figueroa. Easily scoring is Iggy Suarez, the 8th run for Puerto Rico.
Boy, oh boy. Is Puerto Rico having fun right now?
You can say that. A much looser ball club after they got that win yesterday.
Yes, sir. Totally.
Good piece of hitting.
Hit sharply to right center. So what I meant by that was that if you're not going to use him, except maybe I say 4th or 5th outfielder.
And you talk about Abercrombie.
Abercrombie. Then what is he going to do? Play Triple A? And you still have time to do that.
There's another base hit up the middle. Easily scoring is Jesús Feliciano, 9-0 Puerto Rico. So Andy Gonzalez, 2-for-2 this inning, 3-for-3 in the ballgame. He follows the footsteps of Luis Figueroa, who's also 2-for-2 in this inning. Man, Cookie, maybe I want to go hit today.
Oh, my. Those bats are jumping right out of the batting cage. They're alive.
Me hit today, there's no chance. No contact.
And talking about Abercrombie again, you know, he's 27, 28 years old. And if I remember right, Mario Wills came up to the big league when he was 29 years old. Manny Minoso came back to the big league when he was 29 years old and played 10, 12, 14 years. So what I'm saying is that if that ability is wasted and he can't go ahead and adapt himself to the breaking balls and the change of a strikeout a lot, what do you got to lose to be a switch hitter?
Try something else. 9 runs score for Puerto Rico this inning. Foul back. This is a 14th batter here in the third inning, top of the third inning for Leones de Ponce. You saw the big swing by Carlos Rivera. Well, he's 2-for-2, a couple of RBIs. He's stocky, 230 pounds.
Down two outs.
In a game, Cookie, that presents its challenges, especially mentally for the players, knowing that for Venezuela, they've won it. But for Puerto Rico, you know what? They're going out there, pedal to the metal, to a good finish. You got to respect that.
Absolutely.
First and second, 2-2 count. 9-0 Puerto Rico, top of the third. Hoping to get at least 5 innings out of Giancarlo Alvarado for Team Puerto Rico. Try to get him that W. Fooled on the breaking ball. In comes center fielder, but it'll be the shortstop, Nieves, who makes the catch. And after 14 batters, 9 runs in the inning. In Puerto Rico, the big bats by Padilla and company have a commanding lead, 9-0. Dominican Republic takes on Mexico. The final game of this 2009 Caribbean Series has been a success. Tonight on MLB Network, stay tuned as everything will conclude from Mexicali and following a special report on Alex Rodriguez. Oh, Alvarado takes the mound with a 9-0 lead. Good location. As he faces Pedro Gonzalez, the number 9 hitter for Venezuela. At the top of the order, and Rodney Medina and Luis Ugueto. Little cut fastball, and nice sleeping catch by shortstop Luis Figueroa. One out.
Well, he timed that ball very well. Seemed like that ball just was heading straight to center field, but he timed it, jumped, and made a good play on it for the first out. Well, almost hit those birds there.
They're having a great time. Why not? They won their first game yesterday, leading 9-0 right now. A lot of these players will have, some of them only have like a week to 10 days off before they're heading off to Florida or Arizona for spring training camps.
That is true.
And for some of them, Cookie, the sad story is they don't have jobs in professional baseball. They have to wait for offers to come now from either minor league baseball, Mexican league, we mentioned Korea, Taiwan. So it's not all good for everybody. It's not all roses.
Oh, that is true. They probably want to play somewhere along the line. try to keep their family going. And every opportunity that they get, that's why sometimes they want to do a good performance here, because they might get a job in the minor leagues and keep on working
somewhere. A lot of them will end up back here in Mexico for the summer league, a very competitive summer league. 0-2 on the batter, Rodney Medina. He's 0-for-1. So you see all these, so I won't say all of these, but so many players turning down millions of dollars. And then you have players hoping to get paid for a month, maybe just a month.
Very true.
To Figueroa, shows his arm, and there's two down.
Boy, that was a rifle that Figueroa showed there. Going to his left there to grab that line drive for the first out, and then on the ground ball, you see him charging that ball and really showing his arm. That was a rifle shot.
He's got a good arm. There's a look at Luis Maza, who was originally in the lineup. And Bailey decided, yeah, you know what, you take your off day. You're going to big league camp, and we're hoping the best for you. After the rain, I don't want you to come out here and get hurt, even though the field is in excellent shape right now. 8 pitches, 7 strikes so far this inning for Giancarlo Alvarado. Ugueto struck out his first time up. One thing Alvarado is, he has that look of that something in mind, that mission of it doesn't matter what the score is.
Concentration.
That's right. Very intense. Demands a lot out of himself.
Good changeup right there.
Fooled him. Ugueto only 2 for 18 with a couple stolen bases. And it doesn't matter. He's a champ. When you win, nobody asks you, hey, what'd you hit in that series?
Statistics don't mean anything.
When you win, people know
what
that you're a
say?
Winner.
Teamwork.
That's right. Good fastball, but upstairs, 2-2 now. It's a message for so many young players in these days of stats and, you know, sometimes getting away from the team concept. But when you're in a winning team, nobody says, hey, that year that you guys won, what'd you hit? But they always associate you with what? Winning.
That's right.
3-2 now to Ugueto as Hector Jimenez waits on deck. 9-0 Puerto Rico as we play the bottom half of the third inning.
And that's the trend today too, Jose. A lot of the clubs are going after that player that has the fundamentally sound baseball in him, instead of maybe another one that shows you a little more statistic, 300, but you say, well, this man knows how to play the game. He'll move runners over. He'll bunt runners over. He's a good defensive player, fundamentally sound. That's the guy you want in your ballpark.
And a lot of times that's the guy that people notice last, because maybe he wasn't the first round pick or a second round pick or got the big money. But guys that know how to play the game,
very important.
Sometimes they get overlooked, and that's a fact.
Alvarado, 36 pitches, 27 strikes so far today.
Ouch.
Get another one. That's what you really got in your kitchen right there.
Firewood. There's a little cold in Mexico, and Jimenez knows it. And again, since the beginning of the game, when Alvarado jammed Medina, he continues to pound lefties inside.
You don't want those left-handers to go out and stand those arms out there. So he came in real good inside.
Souvenir.
And there's a factory of toothpick. They can do that.
1-1 to Jimenez. Now he works him outside. Another thing, Cookie, we haven't seen this Caribbean series is the bats snapping and flying towards the fielders.
Boy, we saw a lot of that in the big leagues this year, all over. Matter of fact, they were concerned. They were making an investigation about that. There's another one.
As we talk about it, guess what happens?
Yeah.
caught in the air by the third baseman Cortez. He retires, and there's a piece of wood flying. 9-0 after three, Puerto Rico over the champions of Aragua and Venezuela. Coming up after the game, don't miss an MLB Network special report on Alex Rodriguez allegedly having tested positive for steroids during his 2003 American League MVP season. MLB Network's Bob Costas has the first interview with Selena Roberts, the senior Sports Illustrated writer who broke the story. That's an MLB Network special report coming up right after the game. Hey, moving on this game, 2-0 count here. And as Puerto Rico and Jorge Padilla steps up here in the top of the fourth. Grounds it to the right side. Abel Nunez, wide throw by the first baseman. Castro helps him out, one out.
Well, with plenty of time on that throw, the first baseman got off the bag a little bit on the throw and then had time enough to come back and tag the bag for the first out.
Here comes Fernando Cortez. Puerto Rico 9-0, scoring 9 times in the third inning, where they had a total of 10 hits, including 6 consecutive hits against starter Brad Knox.
See, right now we can see from our box they're breaking that glass behind home plate. Because it's pretty dangerous. If they would have left it on, another ball would have hit it. That thing would have been flying all over the place.
Strike 3 on 3 pitches. Cortez is retired by Andrew Lorraine. 2 down.
Good pitch there. The last one on the outside corner. He had no chance whatsoever to even reach that ball. That's the difference, though, when you start throwing strikes and put the hitter back into a defensive position. Like Knox will kind of get him behind 3-2, 2-0, 2-1, 3-1. Very difficult to pitch that way.
Well, Cookie, you put the order for the glass. Look how quick they got that glass, huh?
Oh, that's just paper.
You think so?
No, I'm kidding.
There's a line shot to center field. Langane cuts it off, and Charlie Fermain collects a single. He has struck out 2 times his first 2 at-bats. And that means that every player from Puerto Rico has at least a base hit.
And that was a very good pitch down on a way that he went out and reached it and took it right into center field for a base hit.
Ponce won the series. 1972, playing at the Dominican Republic. In that series, Cookie, Rod Carew was a player manager for Aragua in Venezuela. Don Baylor played in that series. Dave Concepcion, Cesar Cedeño, Sandy Alomar Sr., Jose Cruz, Pat Corrales.
Pat Corrales, yes, sir. He's now with the Washington Senators. Man, a year with the Atlanta Braves. He played with me when I was with the Philadelphia Phillies. Good catcher.
So it's a rich history and continues. And for the first time ever on MLB Network, the Caribbean Series.
We're in the top of the fourth inning. 9-0 Puerto Rico over Venezuela. And this has been a batting practice day for Puerto Rico and Eduardo Perez team.
Gets a corner. Strike 2-2. Throwing some steps. Oh, there we go.
There we go.
That's what happens when you win. Would you dance like that if Billy Martin was your manager? He catch you dancing like that?
Maybe. As long as you already have one, then be all right.
Here's a 3-2 with a man at first. He'll take off. Suarez fouls it. So many things you see in winter ball. See the coffee. The little boy selling coffee. He comes to the dugout during the game. He wants to make money. Nobody's going to stop him. See, all the vendors sometimes stop by the corner of the dugout in all the different leagues. My friends with a glass, be careful. Watch the game.
Fastball up and away. Foul it off. This is what I said about these counts at 3-2. You got to protect that play. Anything close that you think is going to be a strike, or that the umpire might call you out, you better swing at it.
And you've been preaching that all throughout the series. Anything close, don't give the umpire a chance to ring you up. Another 3-2. Right side near the line, Melian in foul territory makes a fine play. We've seen that from Melian all series long.
Good hustle.
And with the score, Puerto Rico 9, Venezuela 0, we'll now send you to MLB Network Studios for a special report. Back to Mexicali, Jackson Melian, Silwin Langana, Ramon Castro. And as we have informed you, after the game, a special with Bob Costa sitting down with Selena Roberts. Who broke the story for SI.com on Alex Rodriguez. Melian, Langana, and Castro against Giancarlo Alvarado, 9-0, Puerto Rico. Great to have you with us again. Jose Mota alongside Cookie Rojas. You mentioned, Cookie, how Alvarado's face is that of a man pitching with a mission.
He certainly is, and very concentrated in what he's doing, too. I mean, he's taking the ball back from the catcher right away. Stay right there in the mound. And he's got a good rhythm going, and he wants just to win this ball game for Puerto Rico.
I told you. Be careful, glass man.
Absolutely. If that other glass would have stayed there, boy, that would have been a big mess.
Somebody tell them to keep their eye on the ball. Well, he moved quickly, didn't he?
Sure did.
He's watching now. And he better. Good pitch by Alvarado. Takes care of Melian. One out. Now four strikeouts for Giancarlo Alvarado. Well, today, how about the average for Puerto Rico so far? 560. 9 runs in the first 4 games. How about 9 runs in 1 inning?
Where's the offense been all these games? You know, now all of a sudden they're having a great time.
The excuse maker, me, Cookie, says it's the shadow not being present.
There's always a reason, right?
Yeah, there's always a reason. In fact,
yeah.
You know what? I admire your generation even more when you played and my dad played and Tony Perez and company and so many of the players even listening and watching today. The hitter's background has become an issue nowadays. But you guys had the fans with white shirts as background sometimes.
Sure, absolutely. There was nothing that you could do about it. You had to go out and play. You know, it's like the managers used to say in that era. It's, what are you complaining about? For what? You're still going to go after there. It's the same for them as it is for us. You got to go get them. What about Candlestick Park? 100-mile-an-hour winds all the time in that ballpark.
It wasn't
sometimes a fly ball to third base end up in right field. You know, and Willie May was the best defensive center fielder you ever saw. I mean, he had no problems. He cut it all over the place.
It is valid to say 100-mile-an-hour wind, as you mentioned, in Candlestick, but it wasn't a warm wind either.
Cold. Yes, sir. But like you said, it's just a matter of going out, getting your mindset, what you're going to do in the field, and forget about all the extra stuff that you don't supposed to be thinking about, the shadow, the wind, grass, too wet, too dry, too hard, too soft. Play the game.
I can see you as a manager saying, hey, play the game, let's go.
That's all you have to do.
Fouled off by Langane, and just watching so many of the fantastic specials we've seen here on MLB Network so far and games of the past. And you go, look at center field. It's not dark. They're hitting against the background of the fans.
Sure. That's right. You know, Jose, this is a kid's game. And all of a sudden, you become a professional.
There's a professional kind of swing by Langane as he spots it to the corner of left field. And he'll have a stand-up double. 2 for 2 for Senwin Langane, the center fielder for the champions. He's aboard with one out.
That was pretty good hitting right there. It's a kid's game, playing professional, and they're paying you. Isn't that great?
Couldn't get better.
Couldn't get better. Quit complaining. Go out and play the game the way it should be played. That's what it's all about. Have fun.
That brings me to a comment made by Venezuela manager Buddy Bailey after yesterday's win when they beat Mexico to clinch the series. He goes, every team in professional and Major League Baseball should make players go to Winter Ball, not ask him to come to Winter Ball. He goes, this will make you a man.
Not only that, but it makes them a chance to work on the things that they have to be successful in the big leagues. If it's a pitcher, he might need a changeup or a curveball or a breaking ball. If it's a hitter, he has to learn to stay back on the breaking ball, hit the ball to right field. See, it's fundamentally their defense to try to get better. So actually, I play like 20 years year-round. 20 years year-round. From 1956 until, my God, I guess it was 1978 or 79 or 80. So, and it was great.
Did you get tired?
Heck no. I had an advantage over everybody when we went to spring training because my arm was in shape, my hitting timely was great, my leg was in good shape. I didn't gain any weight. But the fact is that you kept on playing the game of baseball.
Did you ever lift weights?
No, no weights. None whatsoever. I think you need elasticity in this game. I think you have to have your legs in shape by running. But lifting weights, I didn't have any reason for it. The one thing that you have to learn quickly is what kind of ability do you have. By that I mean, if Cookie Rojas was playing and tried to hit home runs, I would have been back in Cuba a long time ago. But if you learn that you have to bump the ball, move the runner, play the defense, know how to play the game, played all the positions in the big leagues, I played all 9 of them. That's what you have to do as a player.
3-2 to Ramon Castro. Man at second, he fouls it off to the left side. It has been one generational thing after the other, but look at that. You can tell you didn't lift weights.
That was like, I think 160 pounds, 159, 160 pounds when I played.
A lot of rice and black beans.
Sure. And I played against your dad many times, against the Dodgers here and then in Dominican Republic and then in Puerto Rico when we had the Caribbean Series and all that. I saw your dad many, many times. Some kind of hitter.
Up the middle, base hit, look out, pigeons. Feliciano cuts it off. Here's a throw to the play will be cut off as Venezuela's on the board. An RBI single by Ramon Castro. And it's now 9-1 Puerto Rico here in the fourth inning.
Ball hit right through the middle. I love that when I see hitters hitting the ball right in the gaps up the middle. You know, there's time where you look at the way the game is going and you say, I got to get it on base. Well, you try to hit the ball in the left center, right center. Now, if you have a strong, power. Man that can hit the ball out of the ballpark, 2-0, 3-1, 3-2. Then you sit on a pitch middle of the play, middle inside to you, that you can stand and try to pull the ball for an extra base hit. So why do that when, you know, you have, let's say, five runs down, four runs down? What do you do? Hit a home run. What does that do?
Did you ever hit a five-run homer?
You know, that's what I'm trying to say. Exactly. You know? It's a get on base. Bomb the ball. A guy playing third base is in left field. Bomb the ball to third base. Get on base.
Just remember my dad. I was complaining one time on a phone call from the minor leagues. Oh, my God, Dad, I'm like 0 for 13. And he goes, send me a video. Let me look at it. He goes, well, I can tell you one thing. You're trying to get 13 hits in one at bat. Nobody's ever done that.
Absolutely.
Alex Nunez grounded out his first time up. He does it again to the second baseman, to Figueroa, and a flashy shortstop turn. Pitching it with Gonzalez to finish it up, but Venezuela gets on the board. There's the Puerto Ricans doing a little salsa.
Look at them salsa.
Maybe a little mariachi. 9-1, Puerto Rico. Later tonight, don't miss the final of the Caribbean World Series when the Dominican Republic takes on Mexico, Mexico. That's tonight at 9 Eastern, live on MLB Network. Andrew Lorraine on the mound still for Venezuela. He came in relief of the starter Brad Knox. Eli Marrero, Jesus Feliciano, and Luis Figueroa here in the fifth inning for Puerto Rico. They lead 9-1, and it was Marrero who got it started with a single against Brad Knox in the third. And that turned into seven consecutive hits, where Puerto Rico scored nine times that inning. Deep center field, and Langane will catch up with it for out number one.
Boy, he hit that ball a long ways, and it seemed like the ball was carrying all the way from home plate to center field. The wind is blowing.
Cookie, and the change on Knox that we saw on Monday and the one we saw today, drastic.
What a big, big difference there. 6 1/3 innings. Today only 2 2/3. 11 hits. Mm. And 8 earned runs compared to one that he gave up on his first start, and then only 2 strikeouts compared to 5 in the first time he pitched. I mean, it's a total different pitcher today. And I just said to you before the game, if you remember, I don't think he's going to pitch too long. I think he's just going to try to get his certain amount of pitches. I don't think that was the maximum effort that we saw the first time.
I agree with you.
Pitch.
Very happy Puerto Rican team heading back to San Juan. Hoping to go back with 2 wins. It's a deep left field. Not a good job there by Rodney Medina, finally catching up to it. Little twisting and turning. 2 down.
Well, you said the conclusion of this series will come in the second game in this doubleheader today. But then next year, in the year 2010, it goes back to Venezuela, to Margarita. And that's a beautiful island off of the coast of Venezuela.
2010.
So you can start making your plans now to go see the Caribbean Series 2010. And we'll take it to you through MLB Network.
In the air to the left. And Lorraine has a 1-2-3 inning after 4.5. And only 7 pitches that inning by Lorraine. It's 9-1 Puerto Rico. And they're getting ready romantically for Team Mexico. I guess they knew they were on camera. I think they've been to some big league ballpark, because the famous kiss cam nowadays everywhere.
Sure. All over the place.
Everywhere.
They do that in Miami all the time.
There's a swinging strike against Abel Nieves by Giancarlo Alvarado.
Alvarado has now 51 pitches. 17 balls, 44 Ks so far.
Made 21 last inning of those 61 pitches. Alvarado, an outstanding outing his first time out. On Monday, he went 5 2/3 against Mexico, only gave up 5 hits, 2 earned runs, struck out 11. As he faces Abel Nieves and Pedro Gonzalez in the top of the order for Venezuela and Rodney Medina.
The one thing that we see always at Alvarado, you know, he's got a great arm, a pretty good breaking ball and changeup, is that sometimes he stays up, you know, instead of going throwing the ball and going down a little bit. All the time he's staying up, if you watch. Very seldom he goes all the way down.
He did better on that one, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
And he struck him out.
Yes, he did.
And he collects his 5th strikeout. And it comes here, leading out the 5th inning. We were watching the game the other day between Dominican and Mexico, and we were watching Jorge Sosa, who had a very good winter season for Licey in the Dominican. And because of the inactivity, one thing you pointed to me was, Jose, even though he got out of that first inning watch, he's not following through. And before you know what Adrian Gonzalez did that night? You
know, my.
3 home runs.
3 dingers.
And Sosa got lit up. One hopper to the right of the second baseman. Good play by Iggy Suarez, and there's 2 down. Well, we mentioned Gavs on Prime 9, and we've seen a couple of strange things here today. Here's one of them. Without a watch out. Oof.
Broke that glass right behind home plate totally. He woke up that gentleman sitting right behind there taking his little nap.
Our good amigo there waiting.
Yes.
Certainly heard it. Chopper shortstop. Quick release. Good transfer by the shortstop Figueroa. 1-2-3 inning for Giancarlo Alvarado. 9-1. 7 pitches again. The 2009 Caribbean World Series is presented by the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic has it all. Well, Cookie, throughout the series, he talked about taquitos and enchiladas and a little bit of everything, and the whole environment here is so spectacular in Mexicali.
It's been a great experience here in Mexicali with the fans, you know, the players, the different clubs. It's been great. The weather's been great until today. We had a little bit of raining early in the morning, but it was fantastic, and everything has been amazing. Good food, good excitement, good music, and baseball at its best right here in Mexicali, Mexico.
And with the tough economic times all throughout the world, it's great to see the fans come to the ballpark, forget a little bit about it, and what it's still a very affordable scenario for them. On this stage of the Caribbean Series, the turnout has been great.
It certainly has. And I hope they continue year after year in this Caribbean Series along in the different cities and countries that we hope to. And it goes around, as you guys, fans, know. Venezuela, Puerto Rico, Mexico, Santo Domingo.
Andy Gonzalez, Carlos Rivera, and Jorge Padilla here in the 6th inning. 9-1 Puerto Rico. Leones de Ponce. Lorraine misses it outside, and believe it or not, that is the first walk issued to Puerto Rico. Even with those 9 runs on the board, but they've done it all swinging the bats. That'll bring up Carlos Rivera, who's 2-for-3. A couple of RBIs. Rivera. As he talk about staying inside the ball, Cookie, and thinking, something you do use a lot, thinking right center, left center. What is it that that type of thinking does for a hitter?
What it does is that you wait a little longer for the pitch. You see the ball coming to you instead of you going to the ball and not lounging at the ball. So if you stay inside of the ball, it's easier to hit the ball to the middle, left center, right center, so you become a better hitter. When you are trying to get around the ball, there's too many things that go wrong. Your head start going out, your shoulder goes out, your waist, same way. So it's more difficult to be a consistent hitter and for high average, trying to pull the ball instead of utilizing the whole park. Then if you go by count, like I said before, if you get 2-0, 3-1, 3-0 counts, you can sit in the pitch that you can try to pull the ball. But once you fail at it, go back to the middle again.
And as we talk to so many people, youngsters especially, in your opinion, what is a good two-strike approach from the stance part of it and from the mentality part of it?
From the stance mentality, you have to be able to cover the whole plate.
Okay, so should you spread out a little bit more?
Either spread out or come a little closer to the plate or move forward a little bit towards the pitcher. Because a lot of times, sometimes that breaking ball, you can get it too if you get a little movement home plate towards the mound, that if you stay way behind where the ball is way in the outside corner, sometimes you can't reach it. So it's better for you move forward and then you get more chances of hitting that ball. And just to protect the player to the point that if you get two strikes, you have to get the mentality that I'm going to swing at anything that is close, especially with men on bases. How many times you see man on second and third, less than two outs, and letting that hitter take that strike and the umpire ring you?
There's a good approach by Carlos Rivera with two strikes, waiting all the way till the end to see that spin get out of the hitting zone. 2-2. Again, following the ball all the way into the zone.
That's what you have to do.
3-2 now, and Carlos Rivera is Jorge Padilla, who hit a three-run homer in the third inning, waits on deck. There's another look at Luis Maza, the fiery, representing that fighting spirit for Venezuela all throughout the series.
Getting a very well-deserved day off.
In foul territory, the third baseman Ugueto will retire Carlos Rivera for the first out here in the sixth inning. Buddy Bailey making his way to the mound. The manager of the Campeones 2009. Looking for another hurdler to come in and hold down Puerto Rico, hoping for a comeback for his team, looking to go unbeaten. 9-1 Puerto Rico here in the sixth, and we'll be back. Francisco Buteau takes care of sealing the deal, and he knew it when that ball's hit, as Venezuela gets the crown last night against Mexico. First time ever for the Tigres de Aragua. And very happy the whole country down in South America is the wait, the arrival of their champions. And we've seen some greetings sent all over, from Puerto Rico to the Dominican. People asking for money to get back. That's not a good sign. Ivan Blanco on the mound. So glad you could be with us here on MLB Network, presenting the 2009 Caribbean Series. I'm Jose Mora alongside Cookie Rojas. Cookie, 16-year big league veteran, five-time All-Star, 14 years as a coach. Also scouted a whole life of baseball, and a fine family also with your sons involved in baseball. Cookie, congratulations.
Well, the same to you, Jose. I think you come from a great baseball family. They're still in the game. They're still involved with this wonderful game of baseball. It's always been a pleasure to work with you. And as long as we live, we want to be associated with baseball in some capacity.
And your son Victor doing an outstanding job here on MLB Network from the launching. Here's Jorge Padilla, Puerto Rican League MVP, facing Ivan Blanco. So Andrew Lorraine goes 2 2/3, allowing three hits. The runner first, Gonzalez, belongs to him. Lorraine struck out one and also walked one. 46 pitches. Padilla, 3-for-19 now in the series. And the party begins here in the dugout.
Look at those steps. He's really going.
Tied him up with that fastball. 1-2. There he goes. See all the things you learn in Mexico?
That's Horacio Estrada, right?
Looks like him. There's a good piece of hitting by Padilla, and this one will find the grandstand from Emiliano, who throws a second, and he will double up the runner. Gonzalez, who had to freeze, is thrown out. So the putout, 9-6, no hit for Padilla.
Well, you can't blame the runner right there, because he came in and it looks like he was had a chance to catch that ball, so he hesitated. But at one bounce, the right fielder Emiliano got the ball and made a perfect throw to second base and force.
Well, he can smile now, but that would have put Padilla 5-for-20. Cookie, that's a 250 average. That becomes respectable.
Yes, sir.
For a guy that started 0-for-11.
He took away from him a big hit.
There's a ball for the batter, Fernando Cortez. Two down, 9-1. Puerto Rico leading. After this ball game, Uri Berenguer and Dan Plesac will bring the action. The Dominican Republic against Mexico to close out the 2009 Caribbean Series. And that'll be after the MLB Network special with Bob Costas and SI.com senior writer Selena Roberts on the allegations against Alex Rodriguez. There's a 3-1 on Cortez, who's 1-for-3 with a triple. There's a second walk of the inning by Venezuela in pitching, and that'll put men at first and second. So, Cookie, we saw a hitter get thrown out on what appeared to be a base hit to right field. He got thrown out 9-3. Now we see a 9-6. See broken glass like a hockey puck behind the plate. Anything else?
Well, it seems like when the series is over, a lot of things during that happens all the time. As we've seen some weird things going on today in this game and in games prior to this one.
Ooh, watch out, buckling. Oops.
That is embarrassing when you get thrown out of first base from right field, though.
It's a bad feeling.
On this one, it's okay because he thought that he had a chance to catch the ball in the air. And
for Maint, 1-for-3, 2 strikes outs and a single today. Good breaking ball by Ivan Blanco. He shuts it down for Puerto Rico. They ran two runners here in the sixth, but they lead comfortably 9-1. Tonight, don't miss the final game of the Caribbean Series 2009 when the Dominican Republic takes on Mexico. That's tonight at 9 Eastern, live on MLB Network from Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico. Mexicali is the capital, in fact, of Baja California. And now the last day, take advantage. There's some great deals out there. Cookie, did you get something?
Of course, absolutely. Absolutely. Hats and shirts and everything else that we can take home and give it to our kids and a great memory. All the souvenirs that are going on, great prices too.
Here's Luis Ugueto. Venezuela trails 9-1, bottom of the sixth inning. Skies into center field. Feliciano comes in, he makes a catch. Ugueto 0-for-2 now. That'll bring up number 3 hitter and powerful DH today, Hector Jimenez.
Every year that I go to the series, I get all the hats, the different hats of the different teams, take them home, and then wear them during the season.
Wear them to go fishing?
Everything.
Golf? Well,
the ballpark, too.
Wear to the ballpark, too?
Sure. Yes, sir.
Jimenez.
But I bet you get a lot of this. Where'd you get that hat?
Then I show him where they can go get it.
There you go. Tell you what, there's not one thing you cannot get nowadays on MLB.com.
That's
either.
Right. High quality merchandise.
So Venezuela sees Puerto Rico getting in their way as they begin the day at 5-0. Puerto Rico at 1-4. With a comfortable lead here, leading by 8 runs in the 6th inning. Hector Jimenez has had a long Caribbean Series, Cookie, only 1-for-22.
Got to ask you a question now. You manager.
Okay.
You got a 9-run lead. Why would you have your pitcher in a situation like this in the Caribbean Series to let him pitch any longer?
I would have to guess with Eduardo Perez, perhaps the pitch count is not that high on Giancarlo Alvarado. He's allowed 4 hits. And Giancarlo himself, a very strong personality, is admitted by Eduardo Perez. Perhaps said, give me 6 today, no matter what the score is, but you're going to be out of it.
Well, let's see what happens. He's already in the 6th inning. After here. This inning, we'll see what happens.
Here's pitch number 75 is grounded to shortstop by Jimenez. Now 1-for-23, 2 down. And Jackson Melian coming up. That is one reason Eduardo Perez told me. He goes, I got to have Eli Marrero just to keep Alvarado under control with his emotions on the mound.
Well, he's done that. He's been very relaxed on the mound. He's taking his time in between pitches, you know, mixing them up pretty well. Marrero done a great job behind the plate.
Cookie, and I can't say it enough. How good is it to see baseball back in Puerto Rico after the absence last season due to the economic problems with the league?
That was a great step to get Puerto Rico back into the league and to represent their island in the Caribbean Series. Baseball history has gone many, many years in that island that have produced many big names in baseball and will be some more coming in. So it's great to have him back. Including, welcome back, Puerto Rico.
Including number 21, the Carolina Comet. El Cometa de Carolina.
I can honestly say that I consider Puerto Rico my second home. Spent 9 years in Arecibo, Puerto Rico. Played and managed for that ball club. Managed the Santurce Crabbers. Also managing Ponce Leones. Great island, green people.
And Santurce is with Willie Mays and Roberto Clemente, got to play together at one point, huh?
Yes, sir. Many years back. Good effort there by the first baseman. It went over against the fence. Took his eyes off of it and missed that fly ball.
Look out. Looking for that breaking ball over the plate. Jackson Melian, who's 1-for-2 today. Did the right thing. Turn your head.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
3-2, 2 outs. And I don't know if that was so much a ball. You see that. The displeasure shown by Alvarado, but it's the way that Marrero caught that pitch, Cookie, I think that cost him a strike.
That was a strike, though. Wow. No wonder he was mad.
Here it is.
That's in the inside part of the plate. I mean, that was bolos over about 3 or 4 inches over the plate.
Alvarado made 7 pitches in the 5th inning. 13 so far here in the 6th inning as he walks his second batter. Bringing up Selwyn Langane with 2 outs. Here's it to left field again, twisting and turning as a left fielder. Charlie Fermain to make the catch. Melian is stranded. 9-1 Puerto Rico. End of the 6th.
like to wish my daughter Andreana a happy 6th birthday. We love you. We miss you. Mom and Dad's here, but soon in 2 days we'll be there, and we'll be singing happy birthday to you. In the meantime, enjoy your birthday. Love you. Mwah.
Eduardo Perez, 13-year big league veteran, originally signed by the Angels as a first-round pick. And the greetings don't stop, and it's good to see. As I recall many times when my mom and dad went to the Caribbean Series, it's like, what are you going to bring me?
Baseball, a baseball.
I remember getting a watch from Venezuela one time and a little coqui from Puerto Rico, the little frog. Iggy Suarez skies it to the first baseman and foul territory. It is caught by Ramon Castro, one out. In fact, the coqui is a great story, Kugi, as you know very
yes,
well.
That's right.
The coqui is a very small frog that has been proven they can only live in the island of Puerto Rico.
That is right.
Only survive, I should say.
That is true. Why is that, huh?
The native land calls, and that is the only place. And having gotten a chance to go out there to the rainforest, what a fantastic view.
Beautiful island. Beautiful island. All the Caribbean, where we come from. Great weather, great beaches, great people.
Nice breaking ball by Ivan Blanco to Eli Marrero, who's 1-for-3. A happy 75th birthday, Kuki, to Hank Aaron, the Hammer.
Mr. Aaron.
Inside on Marrero.
What a beautiful swing he had.
All wrists, huh?
Yes, sir. And he always hit off the front foot, something that very rarely you see players do. But he could hit the ball all over the park with power. And at the same time, they don't talk about his defense. Hank was an all-around player. He could steal when you needed to. He could throw a guy out when he needed to. Got a great arm, accurate.
How many times did you see him hit a home run, say, 475 feet?
Oof, quite a few. And the line drive. Never hit that ball way, you know, line shots. Got on top of that ball and goes,
still
see
going.
You. Effortlessly.
I recall as a youngster at Dodger Stadium is watching the Dodgers and my dad and going in to see the Braves and the big number 44. He never wore his helmet in the on deck circle. He always walked up there without the helmet to the plate, put it on at the plate. As we see a walk to the hitter here with one out, Marrero walks. We see some action in Puerto Rico's bullpen. Jesus Feliciano will come up. 3-for-4 today.
Had a great night, except he was thrown out, remember? And the first time about to get that bloop single that's to right field, but he didn't run hard. And that's one thing you have to remember, fans. Run hard.
To the shortstop. And they complete the double play, 6-for-3. Good defense by Nieves. Abel Nunez to Ramon Castro to close it out. 9-1 Puerto Rico cruising. A new pitcher for Puerto Rico, and Kuki, as you were questioning, Eduardo Perez makes his move, and Travis Minix comes in from the bullpen to rescue Giancarlo Alvarado.
He's been in two games. There's two innings, allowed 4 hits, 2 runs. No bases on ball, he struck out 2 hitters.
He'll come right after you.
From the Philadelphia Phillies AAA club.
You'll be facing Ramon Castro, Alex Nunez, and Abel Nieves. 6-7-8 for the Campeones del Caribe. Venezuela. And in case he just joined us, Venezuela last night crowned as champions with a big win over Mexico. Big base hits by Maza, RBI by Langane.
Oh, Another one by Chavez.
Chavez had two big RBIs.
They deserve it, Jose, because they have played throughout the series with great enthusiasm, great fundamental of the game of baseball, fantastic pitching, and great relievers. So,
as one of their players was quoted in one of the newspapers in Venezuela today, we did it without the names because we are a team. And it's not about individual names. And one of the names I saw floating around the dugout all throughout the finals with great support was Miguel Cabrera, the slugger for the Detroit Tigers. Led the American League in home runs last season. And he was there every single game pulling for his ball club. As we see what happened last night with Buteau on the mound.
The party started right there.
And Buddy Bailey, after five trips to the Caribbean Series, can proudly show off that flag.
And the fans from Venezuela jump on that field, too, to celebrate with the players. And that was nice to see, too, and the excitement all over the place.
And the hitter, Castro, unable to hold up. He goes down on strikes. Playing the bottom of the seventh inning, 9-1 Puerto Rico. All nine runs came in the third inning against starter Brad Knox, who gave up eight earned runs in 2 2/3. The other one allowed by the reliever Andrew Lorraine in 2 2/3 also. Alvarado, solid outing, six innings, four hits allowed. One run it was earned. A couple of walks. He struck out five, so Cookie Alvarado leaves the Caribbean Series with 16 strikeouts in 11 and a third, or 11 and two-thirds innings.
Actually, he should be going for his second win of the series,
right,
but could not do it on the first time out, even though they struck out 11 batters, and now an easy lead that his club gave him of nine runs. He's got a good chance to end up with his first win of the series. He's pitched very well.
Alex Nunez waves. He's 0 for 2. He's got the Magli Ordonez look there with his hair. Another great Venezuelan slugger, Magli Ordonez. Like Miguel Cabrera, Bobby Abreu still looking for a job as a free agent.
That is shocking. Really shocking. He definitely can help any ball club.
Down goes Maglio here or not is a strikeout for Alex Nunez. Two down. There's Raul Chavez, the big base hit. He's one of the pillars of this ball club.
That is really chucking, like you said, Jose.
Robbie Abreu. He'll walk 100 times, which means he's going to be on base. He'll hit around 300 or 300. He'll drive in 100 runs. His power, he's going to be between 18 to 25 around there. And the only question I can go to is his price still too high? Is he demanding too much still?
Well, that could be one of the reasons, because he still is in pretty good shape. Even though last year he gained a little more weight, you know, he was a little bigger. He's got to lose some weight, go back to the normal playing status. And I think he can help any ball club. Could you imagine him in a club like Tampa?
Do a lot.
Got to do a lot.
Tampa.
What about in Chicago?
There's talk about the White Sox last week. Don't know if it was true or not. The Cubs, too, they talked about him, but Tampa Bay went with Pat Burrell, a proven slugger with the Phillies.
Who do you take between Pat Burrell and Bobby Abreu?
It depends on what I needed, righty or lefty.
Well, I'll tell you, let's put him in one category, a player. Who do you take?
Oh, for sure, Bobby Abreu is
absolutely.
More
he can run better. He can throw better. He's a better defender. He got power. He's going to drive in 100 runs without a doubt. And I think he'll be a great fit. You know, Burrell, you're thinking about the DH. That's what you're thinking about here.
It's a good placement for
him.
In
that ballpark with the turf, if they put him in left field, he'll be a liability.
And not only is that a liability with the turf, but also with the dome.
Exactly.
In Tampa Bay.
And he's not a good outfielder.
Abel Nieves.
You remember the word torero?
Torero?
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
It's a bullfighter.
Yes.
Three times Abel Nieves has gone down. But you know what? The music continues. The festival, carnival, the fiesta here in the Caribbean Series as Puerto Rico cruises. They lead 9-1. And this is only the appetizer to what is promising to be another great international event for baseball, one that was envisioned long, long time ago. And it's good to see already the second phase of the WBC coming up.
It's going to be great baseball to see all of those nations coming over. It's a lot of excitement already, and people are calling all the different ballparks where they are going to be playing to get their tickets ahead of time, and they're going to see a great spectacle of good players and a great relationship between countries. And let's see if we can take away that crown from the Japanese and see if we can bring it back to the United States this year.
The U.S. team will be managed by Davey Johnson. In fact, part of that staff from MLB Network, Barry Larkin.
Barry Larkin is there.
That's right.
Smith is there. Reggie Smith.
Here's Luis Figueroa taking strike one from Jose Guanches, the new pitcher. It'll be number 2, 3, and 4. 9-1 Puerto Rico here in the top of the eighth inning. It'll be Figueroa, Gonzalez, and Rivera. Got jammed on that one to the shortstop. Charging is Nieves, he'll throw him out. And never too late, Kuki, to say thank you to the wonderful staff and supporting cast we've had here this whole week from MLB Network, and so many people helping back in the truck everywhere. It's been tremendous, and so glad to be part of this first MLB Network production of the 2009 series, Caribbean World Series. A marvelous, marvelous job all throughout. Thanks to all of you for tuning in.
Absolutely, great job for everybody, and I definitely congratulate them. And thank you so much for all your help. It's been fantastic throughout the whole series.
Especially Tony Battiti and John Entz. Batter.
Andy Gonzalez.
And there's strike three. And is Angel Molina was hitting for Andy Gonzalez. Molina, who helped us work a camera yesterday, goes down on strikes. And Rodo Perez wanted to give him an at bat. That'll bring up Carlos Rivera.
Tigres pitching and struck out the last four batters in a row.
There's a big swing by the big man. So Jose Guanches becomes a fourth pitcher for Buddy Bailey in his Venezuelan ball club. There's Ricky Bonas, pitching coach for Puerto Rico. They had the best ERA of any ball club coming into this series during the regular season. And pitching really hasn't been a problem for Puerto Rico. Down the line foul. Carlos Rivera. Still alive, he's 2 for 4. He came into this game at 350. He is now 9 for 24 in the series. to the right side on one knee, fielded by the second baseman Abel Nunez, and a 1-2-3 inning for Jose Guanches. As Puerto Rico goes down here in the top of the eighth, but they lead 9-1. The 2009 Caribbean World Series is presented by the Dominican Republic. The Dominican Republic has it all. Well, what hasn't happened lately is offense, even though Puerto Rico does have 9 runs on the board, Venezuela 1. No hits for either side since the bottom of the fourth inning. And I think, Cookie, that's when players decided we got to go up there and hack.
That was unbelievable. The whole offense just came out in the third inning where they had 13 hitters come up to the plate.
9 runs in the top of the third inning for Puerto Rico. Pedro Gonzalez grounds it to the mound where Minix will throw him out. And Minix has retired all 4 batters he has faced, including striking out the side in the seventh inning. So Buddy Bailey making his 5th appearance in the Caribbean Series finally gets to win one. The first title for Venezuela came back in 1970 when Magallanes won the series. And here's some names, Cookie, you're going to like. You know who played center field for Magallanes that year? Cesar Tovar.
Tovar, yes, I played with him in Caracas.
Managed by Carlos Patato Pascual.
Brother of Camilo Pascual.
Left side, and now able to field it cleanly as a shortstop, Figueroa, and he'll have an error.
Try to rush it a little bit there.
And we have a new shortstop for Puerto Rico, a youngster getting an opportunity to play. And that is, well, that is Iggy Suarez. Iggy Suarez now at shortstop. It's about feeling, come into the game right away and boot it. Oof. I've been there.
Well,
it doesn't feel good. Ugueto takes the pitch outside. No hits allowed for either team since the fourth inning. Runner getting aboard here in the eighth by an error. 9-1 Puerto Rico. Looking for their second win to finish off here the Caribbean Series. And tonight it'll be the Dominican Republic, Tigres del Licey, Licey Tigers, against host Mexico. And Venados de Mazatlan, the Mazatlan Deer. Travis Minix on the mound for Puerto Rico. Good pitch on Ugueto. He goes down swinging. He is 0-for-3.
Got him on a good changeup, down and away. Turning the ball over. Been throwing pretty good today. Great control. Look at that ball going down. It's a good pitch, like a screwball versus left-handed hitters.
Dominican Republic and Mexico later tonight. Uri Berenguer with a play-by-play. And our good friend Dan Plezak with a commentary. Good changeup again, Cookie. Right there by Minix on Jimenez.
He's doing what pitching should be doing and getting ahead of the hitters, and then he got him off balance with a changeup.
It looked like Figueroa moved over to second, giving Suarez a chance to play second base. One, two down, bottom of the eighth inning, 9-1. It's all been Puerto Rico in one inning so far, marks a difference. 9 runs for Puerto Rico, top of the third inning, 1 run scored by Venezuela. That came in the bottom of the fourth. And the flip-flop continues between the second baseman and the shortstop. This time it's from Suarez to Figueroa to finish it off. 9-1, Puerto Rico. This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Caribbean Confederation of Professional Baseball and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without express written consent of Cultiva Entertainment. Moving on to the top of the ninth, and a broken bat to the right side of the ground ball. And retired for Puerto Rico's number five hitter, Jorge Padilla. Well, Cookie, we mentioned we haven't seen any wood flying around. Now, this game, we've seen two of them. Snap.
Well, we were talking about a little bit early in the game, you know, that we haven't seen too many pitches thrown inside. A couple of guys have done that during this series, but that's the only way that you're going to get a hitter to break their bat. If you come in into the kitchen and sometimes throw a changeup and you get him off balance, hit him in the end of the bat, and those bats snap. But what amount of bats have broken this year in the National American League, it was amazing.
It was so much, in fact, and it presented so many dangerous situations and scenarios that there's a lot of research done, and I believe there's going to be some changes implemented starting very soon in the big leagues. Jose Guanches on the mound. Fouled off by Fernando Cortez.
Left-hander pitcher.
Don't forget, after the game, special report. Bob Costas sits down with Selena Roberts, SI.com senior reporter, on the allegations against Alex Rodriguez. And there's a strikeout. Out number two as Cortez goes down. And this lefty, Guanches, Cookie, showing a lot of good stuff. Five retired in a row.
Yes, he has. He's got pretty good breaking ball. And he's tough versus left-handed batters.
Charlie Fermín has struck out three times. He's 1-for-4 in the game. And for Venezuela in the ninth, Jackson Melian, Selwyn Langane, and Ramon Castro. Is one thing they know for sure, Cookie, no matter what, they win the series.
No question about it.
So we can't say there's any back against the wall or anything like that.
No, sir. And they did it right, too.
You know what? After three strikeouts for Mantis, 1-for-4, if I'm him, I'm going to see how far I can hit this one.
It's going to go all the way out, huh? There he is.
Why not?
Why not is right.
You can't be so programmed in this game to go, you know, let me look for contact. Yeah, forget that. I struck out three times.
No, not right now in a game like this. 9-1. Yeah.
Let it fly.
Absolutely.
No chance. He goes down for the fourth time. A good outing. Six in a row retired by Guanches. As Venezuela is trailing by 8. Going on to the bottom of the ninth inning. In Venezuela, last night they clinched the Caribbean Series title. They're trailing by 8 runs. And the new pitcher, Edward Buzachero, on the mound. He'll face Jackson Melian, Selwyn Langane, and Ramon Castro. Melian had a double in the second, struck out swinging in the fourth, a walk in the sixth. Misses outside. And tonight, don't forget, Dominican Republic against Mexico. After the Bob Costas special here on MLB Network. Line to the right side, and this will be a foul ball. Thank you. Venezuela with Aragua last night clinched their seventh title. Good breaking ball, and down goes Melian. That is strikeout number 10 overall for Puerto Rican pitching.
They've done a good job from the mound today, and everything got together, the hitting and the defense, played good defense, and they're going to take him to the second win of the series.
Venezuela won his first title, as mentioned before, in 1970. Then they won in 1979, and well, Puerto Rico looks like a team celebrating. What a great time. Venezuela won in 82, 84, 1989, and 2006. Now the new champions in 2009. In fact, Venezuela has been absent a couple of times, Cookie, because of players' strikes.
True.
There were a couple of years when the Caribbean Series was tried in U.S. soil in Miami. Didn't have quite the same flavor.
Sure didn't. They were playing in the wrong place, too. I mean, it's impossible to play in the Orange Bowl Caribbean Series.
1-1, Langana is 2-for-3. He skies it out to the left side. Chandler Fermain puts it away, and Puerto Rico is one out away. Alex Rodriguez, steroid allegations, special report on MLB Network tonight, reaction and analysis from Harold Reynolds and Tom Verducci. Bob Costas sits down with Sports Illustrated senior writer Selena Roberts all after the ball game. Last hope for Venezuela is Ramon Castro. Puerto Rico looking to finish with 2 wins and 4 losses, Cookie. And one out away from giving Venezuela their first loss, they would go to 5-1 and still remain the champions. Many, many fans making their way in for tonight's ball game. The Gonzalez brothers in Mexico against the Dominican Republic of Jose Offerman. There's ball forward, 2-at-walk to Ramon Castro. We'll put a runner aboard here for Venezuela. And I think he's hearing from some of his teammates, hey, swing the bat.
Well, he's, you know, nibbling a little bit there in the corner. Says you got a big lead of 9 runs, you know, to one. And said, throw the ball right over the plate, right in the middle of the plate, and see what happens. You don't even worry about that running on first base.
He even threw a changeup. How about that?
Right in the middle of home plate. Amazing.
Hey, he's working on things.
Yeah, it sure is. That's a good pitch right there, and call him a ball.
But he continues to nibble. In fact, he stared home plate umpire in that case. 1-1 count for the batter, Alex Nunez, 0-for-3. This could be it. Shortstop steps on the bag, and Puerto Rico wins their second ball game and gives Venezuela their first loss. 9-1 the final, and we'll have more right after this.